accountants from Ernst & Young.
Oh, genius.
Rachel.
I was looking for Oprah. Where was Oprah?
I'm not looking at her. I will say the one person I did lock eyes with was Elizabeth Moss from A Handmaid's Tale.
So cool.
And she was smiling and laughing, and I went up to her, and I said, I just wanted to thank you for being such a wonderful audience member, because there's nothing like performing live. I mean, I've done stand-up shows where you look at the audience and you just catch stink face. And it was so great. The one person I locked eyes with was like, yeah! And so it was so great.
Are you watching that show? People are obsessed.
Not yet, because I need to be in an okay headspace where I can be depressed. And right now, I'm in the middle of doing my show.
Well, and let's talk about depression, because I know that's something that you have dealt with and you've been very open about. You wrote about it in Glamour in an essay. And it's also something your character, Rebecca, is dealing with.
Yeah, tenfold. Yes. I mean, I think that, you know, like, everyone's got stuff. Everyone's got problem. I think that some people have it more than others. And just like going to the doctor for a cold, you know, there are ways to treat all sorts of mental ailments. I mean, really, you can call it like mental illness. You can call it depression. But what is preventing you from living your best life? What is what is preventing you from being happy? And that's why when we talked to doctors in preparing to diagnose my character this season, they were like, you know, the diagnosis is really... that's just like a tool for us to find what's the treatment that's gonna help you feel better. So it's not about like these labels or these diagnoses, it's what's gonna help you kind of like live your best life and be your best self. So that was interesting.
What about the labels and the stigma that still go along with that for some absurd reason? Like, is that ever gonna change? And were you ever nervous about writing that into the script?
I mean, we weren't nervous. It was so kind of part of the show to begin with, the idea of doing a romantic comedy that takes a dark look at romantic comedy is inherent in someone moving across the country to be with a boy, which is what my show's about. It's like, well, this person is not stable, this person is not happy. So that was always part of the show. You know, the stigma of mental health is quite interesting, and I think it partially stems from the fact there's so much about the brain that we still don't know, that doctors still don't know. I mean, you have this book called the DSM, which is where all of the kind of mental disorders are listed, and it's constantly changing, constantly evolving. Then the labels are changing, and so there's so much about the brain. And then also mental illness in women, you know, for a long time people thought when women were mentally ill that it was a disease of the reproductive organs. I mean, the idea of hysteria, it comes from, I think, I'm not that smart. It's some Latin word relating to like the reproductive organs. So there's also, when it comes to mental illness in women, a lot of stigma, because it was seen as kind of like a failing of the gender for a long time.
Yeah. You go deep in the studies there.
It's a lot.
Yeah. It's a lot.
It's a lot. It's heavy.
But you've talked about, you know, you were just joking about insomnia, but sleep anxiety, that's something that is so relatable to so many people.
Oh, man. And right around the time we were pitching Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, I got real bad sleep anxiety. And it was something, I mean, it changed my life, basically, because I was like, I have to stop this. And so that's when I got a really good doctor. I got a really good psychiatrist, and I got into like meditating, which I never thought I'd be that person. I know that sounds so Hollywood, but this is before I had a show. I just, and it was really interesting, because I realized that I had associated, I've been with my husband for a long time, and whenever I was sleeping alone, the idea of like being in the dark alone with my thoughts, and my thoughts were just like spiraling and spiraling. And I realized that the way I was going to sleep when I was alone was making myself so exhausted that I couldn't help but fall asleep. And that's not healthy.
Wow.
Well, the interesting part is that those thoughts, though, actually can translate to your show, the positive, like the creative genius that goes on inside.
Yeah, I mean, it's like anxiety is kind of that flip side, that evil twin of creativity, right? I mean, it's your brain coming up with things. The difference is how to differentiate the two. And I think that's always the struggle for writers and actors is, well, my anxiety makes me who I am. I don't want to like dampen that creative side by like getting treatment or taking a pill for it. And if you find a good doctor and good treatment, only the good parts remain.
Yeah.